I'm a senior footwear designer in Heritage.
My name is Brian Keating, and I'm head of product design here at K-Swiss.
In the past couple years, a lot of big, white, chunky shoes have been kind of a big trend lately. And the 90s thing has been a huge influence on that.
I think it's authenticity is really what's on trend right now. So obviously there's a lot of 90s and early 2000s nostalgia, and we were a really popular brand back in those days.
The golden era of K-Swiss was in the 90s and the early 2000s. They really flourished with chunky white sneakers, this kind of design focus of baggier silhouettes and kind of logo branding and different detailing on the sneakers that really enabled this kind of 90s and early 2000s look.
I think today, kind of a head-to-toe look is really important. And we've got a, again, just like our shoes, we've got a really deep and rich archive of just some really cool apparel. You know, obviously big branding is really popular right now, so, you know, big logos and taping and color blocking. And that was our aesthetic again back in the 90s. We were looking all over the place to try and find some of these, you know, authentic styles. eBay, we were buying stuff off eBay like crazy, just, you know, finding these gems and bringing them back. And what's amazing is they again, these products that are, you know, 20, 30 years old, they look like they could have been designed yesterday, you know, from some of the, you know, the top streetwear brands right now.
I think people gravitate towards Heritage because it really talks about this transparency to longevity. We're living in such a disposable time of the internet and social media and everything. So people, I think, are starting to really question about what lasts. And I think people start looking at brands that have lasted and brands that have been around for a long time. And Heritage plays a big part in this because I think people like the fact that a brand has survived for this long. And K-Swiss is one of the few brands, especially footwear brands, that have been around for 50 years. And so I think people really appreciate that kind of longevity. And I think there's a connection to that, that something that's been around so long, there's almost like a level of respect that, you know, there's only a few brands that have really stood that test of time.
When I started here 2 years ago, you know, we weren't in PacSun, we weren't in Foot Locker, we weren't in Foot Action, we weren't at Shoe Palace and Finish Line. You know, so like we've made a lot of progress in the right direction, and now we're adding apparel to the mix, which is a complete game changer. I think the footwear told a big part of the story, obviously because we're a footwear brand, but I think the apparel ties it all together. So as we're marketing for this, we want to make sure that nothing feels forced. Like, so, you know, we're doing a lot of seeding, a lot of influencer marketing. You know, we're trying to reach people, but in a way that is not trying to force it down your throat. So I think that's probably been the change in strategy, is where, you know, sometimes when you're marketing, it's like you push, advertise, you know, and put it out there in a way that feels inauthentic. And I think for this, we've really wanted to, we've gone to the sources, the people who really genuinely like the brand and support the brand, and not making it feel like it's inauthentic. So the Heritage apparel is available now. And if you want to check it out, go to kswiss.com, K-S-W-I-S-S.com. And not only check out the apparel, but all the great imagery and a lot of the content that we've created to really help tell the story.